Good evening, everyone. Welcome to TV 24 News. I'm Carl Brady. Today on TV 24, we'll continue our look back into the past with the year 1990. In 1990, George Bush was president and Dan Quayle was vice president. The world population was around 52 billion people. The median household income in the U.S. was $29,943. The national unemployment rate was 5.6%, and it only cost 25 cents to mail a first-class letter anywhere in the country. It was also in 1990 that Iraqi troops invaded the small country of Kuwait, setting off the Persian Gulf War. South Africa freed Nelson Mandela, and the Hubble Space Telescope was launched on April 25th. In the entertainment world, The Simpsons debuted on the Young Fox Network and became an instant hit. NBC's Seinfeld was one of the most watched TV shows ever. The Best Picture Oscar went to Driving Miss Daisy, and Dances with Wolves and Goodfellas were a couple of the top movies of the year. In the music world, Milli Vanilli admitted their lip-syncing of their hit songs. The record of the year was Wind Beneath My Wings by Bette Midler. Other top songs of 1990 were Something to Believe In by Poison, Nothing Compares to You by Sinead O'Connor, Madonna's Vogue, You Can't Touch This by MC Hammer, and Cherry Pie by Warrant. And finally in sports, the 49ers of San Francisco stomped the Denver Broncos 55-10 in the Super Bowl, and the Reds swept the A's 4-0 in the World Series. Now, wait a minute, folks. We do have some late-breaking news. I'm getting word that we do have some reporters in the field, and they have just confirmed. Let me see. Yes. Oh, wow, you're not going to believe this. This is a huge story for TV 24 News. Long-awaited, huge breaking news story today concerning Britney. No, not Britney Spears this time. Britney Williams. Britney Williams is actually going to graduate from high school. After all the years of complaining, way too much socializing, primping, and, well, you know, the list just goes on. She is actually going to do it. This determined, strong-willed young lady set her mind to it, and she did it. And for those of you who are fans of Britney, Britney Williams will be hitting the stage of the Bilo Center in front of a record crowd. Now, I'm being told that we have a TV 24 crew live on the scene in Greenville, South Carolina, and that we have established a special satellite link, and it's all set up and ready to go. So please help me welcome to the show today Britney's parents, Jimmy and Christina Williams. Well, Jimmy and Christina, welcome to TV 24 News.
Thank you, Carl, for having
us. Thank you for having us.
Now, as Britney's parents, did you ever have any doubts that this day would ever come?
Well, let's just put it this way. I lost the bet.
I'll take that.
Now, we've all heard the rumors, but is it true that Britney believes that the universe revolves around her?
It doesn't.
What?
I thought it did.
Now, does she ever share her opinions with others?
That's news to us.
Now, I also hear that she puts her own spin to the English language. What's that all about?
Whatever.
What kind of things are you talking about here?
I don't know what you're talking about. Or why can't I go?
Now, Jimmy and Christina, let's just get down to the nuts and bolts of this story. Exactly what kind of student was Britney?
Well, Carl, she was a great student, but the teachers are the ones who really didn't know what they were talking about.
Those damn teachers.
Were there any classes that she excelled in?
Drama. She practiced that a lot.
Especially at home.
I've got to be honest with you. We've all heard story after story about Britney's strong-willed and independent nature. So share with us some of the challenges of raising such a child.
Those are just damn rumors.
Yes, it wasn't really a challenge at all. I mean, Britney always said yes, ma'am, to me and yes, sir, to her father. We never experienced anything like that. There was never a fight whatsoever.
Very polite. Always polite.
Jimmy, Christina, I know you must be very proud to be Britney's parents right now. Thank you for taking a few minutes out of your celebration to join us.
Yes, thank you for having us, Carl. We are very proud of her.
Just keep this off the record. This is off the record, isn't it?
Well, folks, I did have all this other news to share with you today, but you know that stuff's no big deal now. The breaking story we just had beats it all. Britney Williams is graduating from high school. So from all of us at TV 24 News, congratulations, Britney. Have a great night.
Let's Let's go back to 1989 and see how good my memory serves me. Jim, Chris, and Kristen lived at 9A Pointer Lane in a two-bedroom condo we rented from Steve Smith. We decided Kristen needed a sibling. My mom drove up here to be here for the birth. She was here for 4 weeks. I won't go into the details of what she put me through to get this baby here. That is a totally different story. Brittany Marie was born on July 30th, 1990, after being induced and in labor for 12 hours. She weighed in at 9 pounds, 13 ounces, and was 21 inches long. She had a bald head with a little peach fuzz and the biggest blue eyes you've ever seen. We all took turns holding her and adoring her. She was a little fussy at the hospital, but most kids are. Guess what? It did not stop. She cried literally for 3 months. Nothing wrong with her, just nothing made her happy. I went to Mom's in Alabama to see if she could help. Still nothing. It was hopeless. Jim went out and bought our first house that we could all call our own. We moved to 109 Colmont Court. Kristen loved her so much, she even crawled into the crib and held her hand until they both went to sleep. She was the best second mommy, always taking care of her baby Brittany, but looking at this video, she might have been a little rough sometimes. Brittany loved bath time with Kristen. She was beginning to like the water, so we took her to Panama City when she was one. We joined Nana Kratz and the Simmons. She did not feel the same about the ocean water. Jim held her and tried to make her happy. We came home and celebrated Brittany's first birthday with family. That cake was good. Brittany walked at 1 year old, and she had this little snorting, squinty-eyed look. We called it Popeye and always told her to do it for us. Brittany always had a bottle or eating, and as you can see, Bev did not mind the food kisses, but Uncle Terry was trying to escape.
Hey, let's just wave.
Give him a kiss, bye-bye.
Let's just wave.
Give him a kiss.
Give me a high five.
She wants a kiss.
There. All right, get out of here.
Brittany had her first pony ride, carnival rides, roller coaster ride, and sitting in the arms of an Indian. She did not like sitting in the tree, though all the activity might have gotten to her at the large age of one. It didn't matter where we were, here, Michigan, or somewhere else, we always enjoyed spending time with family, having big birthday celebrations, swimming, playing in the leaves, and of course, always being a cheese for the camera. Don't let me forget Brittany's first rodeo, where she and her sister wore cowboy hats. We made our rounds visiting relatives, and this time it was in Alabama celebrating Christmas. We were at my mom's house where we did a little roughhousing and horsey riding. I am the horse, of course. We went to Papa William's house in Birmingham, Alabama. Some wise guy decided to give Brittany and Ashley cell phones that made noises. Ashley and Brittany loved to push the buttons on these phones while sitting in their little red car. Then a secret trip to the bathroom led to a new haircut. Brittany used Papa William's mustache scissors and cut off the hair on one side of her head. We had to go to a boy cut. People would always come up to Brittany and said, "Oh, look at the cute little boy." Brittany used to get so mad, so we got her ears pierced. Well, some people still said it. She was just furious. I think Katie felt sorry for Brittany with that hair and decided to love on her a little bit. And Papa Williams, too, since when I said no, he would always come along with a yes. No, come to think of it, he did this all the time. Brittany always posed for the camera, especially after getting her way. We have always valued our time with family and traveling. We enjoyed some time with great-grandpa and Grandma Carmer at their house in Punta Gorda, Florida, where we picked oranges from the tree in the front yard. We golfed, swam, and played putt-putt. We went to Disney for Brittany's first time when she was 3. Brittany adored Mickey. Anytime we were near beach, we were on it. We had to force Daddy sometimes. He doesn't share the same passion. Lounging around the house, Brittany would always be in some type of Barney wear and cowboy boots. Barney and Baby Bop were her favorite characters. She had the clothes, toys, and all the videos. It snowed north of Greenville one year, so Daddy drove us up there. We put Brittany in the snow and she did not like it. Before Brittany had turned 4 years old, she had broken her arm twice from falling off the bed and cut her neck open with a piece of glass. The people at the hospital would just look at me funny, and I just knew DSS was going to do an investigation. Brittany would watch Kristen cheer at the YMCA, and she memorized the cheers and did them around the house all the time. Well, at least portions of it. There was Rowdy, Lean Lean, and How Loose Is Your Goose. Guess what? Lauren arrives. Brittany got to be the big sissy this time, holding her, loving on her, and feeding her. Brittany would just stare at her until someone woke up or became vocal. She was out of there then. I can always say when I was home on maternity leave, there was always some kind of performing going on that kept us all entertained. Nana Kratz took me, Kristen, and Brittany to Myrtle Beach, where we tent camped in the site right off the beach. Brittany was still a little scared of the ocean at this time. We moved to 520 Snowmill Drive in Reedville, South Carolina. We put in a pool and had 14 acres of land where the kids liked to roam. Brittany was 4 years old when she learned to swim in our pool. Fun birthday parties, pool parties, and just fun with family and friends is how we spent our time. There was one time she was four and trying to make fart noises with her hands. Unsuccessful she was, however, she ended with a hmm and a look like she accomplished what she set out to do. Brittany was always aware the camera was on and was the ham or the drama queen, one of the two. She loved to ask why and of course argue with authority. We went to Nickelodeon when it came to Greenville, and we were chosen from the crowd to sit in the big orange couch and even go on stage and play. We always participated and dressed for Halloween. Sometimes they were homemade outfits, but I kind of think those were the best. And the girls never minded as long as they looked scary. Brittany and Ashley were two peas in a pod, and Ashley spent a lot of time out at the house with us, into mischief and of course dance routines all the time. Brittany was not real good at sharing, especially her new Sony with Ashley. There was one time when they knocked the gear out of Don's Honda on Colmont Court and the car went rolling down the street, picking up speed. They both bailed, of course, but the car drove right into someone's house. No one was hurt, but the house was and had to be fixed. We never really got the whole story on that one. Brittany loved to cheer and decided to cheer for her own team, the Cowboys. Brittany always acted tough, but really wasn't. Kristen was driving at the age of 9 in the field out back. We would get cruising around 25, and as the grasshoppers slammed against the windshield and the car bounced around, Brittany would be in tears screaming we were all going to die. Guess what? Here comes son. Finally a boy. All the girls doted on this baby boy. Now as I look back, Brittany was always fine with taking care of her siblings. It is just when they got old enough to talk back to her or get into her stuff that she had a problem with them. We went back to Disney when Brittany was 6. She was more into mermaids this trip than she was Mickey. We decided the golf cart was fun for the kids, but something with a little bit more speed would be good. So we got the kids their first go-kart for Christmas. They loved driving and riding, and when it snowed, we used it like a snowmobile to pull the sled. Speaking of snow, when we get some, we took advantage of it playing and building snowmen. We knew it would be gone before we knew it. The kids always thought their daddy was cool, and he had tattoos. So they thought they would get some too, and here they are modeling their tattoos. These were not real, of course. It wasn't long that the go-kart caused a problem.
Look at my baby. Broke her leg. In two places.
Nana Kratz and Kristen were driving the go-kart when Brittany decided to play chicken, and let's just say the chicken did not win. Her leg was completely broken through both bones and her foot was dangling. After adult doses of morphine and a little time, she was as good as new, performing in her dance routines. We all just loved the Miss America performance.
Speech on TV. someday, betcha a million. Someday, make it a trillion. I'll be Miss America. One dick, two dick, three dick, four dick. Jump out, jump in, jump out, turn around. One dick, two dick, three dick.
We had a new member in the family, and the girls were in the wedding when Papa Carmer married Sue. Sue made the dresses that the girls wore. At this age, being goofy and having fun was what life was all about. Brittany had her first experience with boobies. Kristen, Lauren, and Brittany all dancing with water balloons for boobies. Brittany always participated in drama and chorus, of course, anything that involved dress up. Brittany took her first airplane ride to Utah to stay at Aunt Nancy's for the Cheadle reunion. Brittany got to enjoy dressing up like a cowgirl and having her first real horse ride. At this time, the two front teeth were gone. Nice smile. Music at the house was still a huge part of our fun, where she tried drumming, singing, and playing the guitar. At the age of 8, she got to go to her first concert. It was the Backstreet Boys in Charlotte, North Carolina. My ears rang for weeks, not from the loud music, from the screams of my girls who had the biggest crush on these boys. We decided to get a new puppy, and it was Sir Spanx-a-Lot Williams, Mr. Spanky. He was the cutest little thing, and this was my Mother's Day gift in 1998. As the years went by, Brittany became a little more vocal, the looks began, and sometimes she just wasn't happy, especially with a bird on her head. Brittany loves the beach, and she liked to surf and look for shells and crabs. There was one time we were there and she found all kinds of crabs and starfish that she captured for a few hours and then set them all free. She protected all the animals at this time in her life. We were very involved in church and always had a lot of activities for the kids. Brittany sang and had acting parts for every church event. She loved God and gave her life to Christ and was baptized on June 14, 1998 by Les Cooper. Acting carried on through school. Plays and Colonial Day were always fun. Brittany enjoyed karate and got all the way to her green belt when I decided we would not continue pursuing, when I had to live down there 3 times a week, about 3 hours a night. Christmas was always big at our house. We started a tradition of waking the kids up to the same song over the years. They would hear the song playing loudly and would wake up and come down to see what Santa had brought. We knew it was special to us, but did not realize that they thought it was special also. Brittany told me she was going to do the same thing with her kids one day. Brittany did not mind sharing her birthday celebrations with Nana Williams. Their birthday was just one day apart. They did a lot of this throughout the years. Brittany never lost her sense of humor, and as she got older, anything for a good laugh, like the Bubba teeth. We thought that was just hilarious.
Baby, yeah. Shut it down.
The family was pretty spread out. Grandparents here, Michigan, Alabama, and Wisconsin. And we tried to make sure that the girls got to spend as much time with them as possible.
No, all right, ready to move.
I need to, I'm digging or something. I haven't got to work on this, and he has.
Jimmy, let her dig for a minute. Just for a minute, and then she'll get back to you.
Give me it.
Since you wanted one of that, then get it.
Give me it.
Give her the little one. Let her get in there.
Shut up! You shut up.
Y'all love each other, don't you?
No, I don't.
You love each other, don't you?
I don't like her.
Hey, look at her butt. Mom, I'm looking at your face.
It was always like home, no matter where we went. A little sibling rivalry going on with someone all the time. And as I look at this one, is that one bunny ear or is that a bird? We quickly outgrew our home in Reedville and we had to get a bigger house. We had a house built at 18 Summercrest Circle in Simpsonville, South Carolina. Brittany received awards for honor roll and perfect attendance until middle school, same as Kristen. Brittany decided she would take her musical talent out of the house and into the school as she played the clarinet for the band. It did not last long, but we enjoyed some good trips out of it. I chaperoned the trips to Tennessee and to Six Flags. Brittany loved winter sports, so we had a tendency to visit Dad and Sue in the winter instead of the summer. We spent a lot of time sledding, building tunnels, and just playing in the snow. It was a rarity in South Carolina. Brittany got a motorized scooter for Christmas one year. It just wasn't powerful and poked down our street, so we took it back and got her a dirt bike. She fell one time when we were riding the dirt tracks and had hurt her wrist. She never rode again. She stuck to letting her daddy ride her around. Jimmy and I always shared a lot about our childhood that included how and where we were raised. I took the kids to Keener one year. We looked for fossils in the chert pit, looked at the caves in the mountains, and enjoyed some fun in what is now a shallow creek but was my swimming hole and my bathtub depending on the well. The kids always enjoy trips to Alabama sightseeing. It goes to show our kids today still appreciate simple things in life. Brittany had a tendency to want to be grown up and then again wanted to do little girl things. Brittany cheered for the YMCA basketball team with Lauren. Then big girl syndrome hit again and we were off to Kelly's in Indiana where she only had to be 13 to get her belly button pierced. Unlike South Carolina, no doctor's excuse was necessary. Brittany got into sports a little late in life too. It was at the age of 14 she decided to play softball. She signed up with her best friend Tiffany and Lauren. She found out she was a great pitcher and with no past experience, she had all the moves down in no time. I love these pictures we took. She was going to try out for softball, but due to her going into her sophomore year, the way the school system is set up, she would not be able to play until she was a senior. So she decided she would just cheer again, and she cheered for the Hillcrest High Rams basketball team. The kids went to Michigan some in the summer, even though I could not always go. Sue and Dad would meet halfway, and off they would go. Brittany took her boyfriend one year and Ashley another time. Over the years, they enjoyed fishing, going to Mackinac Island, the sand dunes, spending time in Cadillac at Dad and Sue's camper, and always fun just hanging out in Swartz Creek, riding the tractor and swimming. We also did a lot of volunteer work over the years. We participated in the March of Dimes, Relay for Life, and spent a day at the soup kitchen downtown feeding the homeless. We loved North Carolina, where she learned to ski, and then one year did a little bull riding. We also went back to Disney and camped in Orlando. It was there that Brittany and Kristen rode the slingshot, and that was exactly what it did. The human in this ride was like the stone you shoot out of a slingshot, straight up in the air on some rubber bands, heavy-duty ones, of course. Still, it was very scary. By now, Brittany was driving around. She has a little Honda stick shift, no power windows, no air conditioning, but she was driving. She did complain some, but it is still driving to this day. Even though she had had a lot of freedom to do what she wanted, she still wanted to spend time with us. She would bring friends sometimes, but she still wanted to be there. We spent a lot of time at the lake. Brittany did a lot of knee boarding and riding Big Bertha. I knew she was invited to parties and stuff on the weekends, but she was with us instead, and that meant a lot to me and Jim. She stayed focused on school pretty well, A's, B's, and C's. And I can honestly say, Brittany never really gave us too hard of a time. The times that Brittany got in trouble were due to running her mouth, never really understanding that you really never win with your parents just because you get the last word in, especially with Jim. Though there were a few boyfriends, there was not one who lasted as long as Damon. As our friend Buddy would say, he is Mr. Wonderful, someone who apparently appreciates a strong woman. Damon and Brittany went to junior prom. Brittany decided that she would go stag to the senior prom. Nothing wrong with Mr. Wonderful, she just wanted to do the last prom with just her friends. Brittany and I have always been close. She's not a real open person, and sometimes I have to really work to get her to open up, but eventually she does. We have had our ups and downs along the way, but we always make up. She always knew that being a parent was my first priority, with rules and expectations, but yet a friend she could always depend on. Strong relationships is something Jim and I have instilled in our children. We believe in building these relationships with both family and our friends. Brittany has grown up experiencing this from a lot of you. The time, wisdom, and love we have given her through the years is apparent in this young woman that stands before us today. Brittany, those eyes, they are breathtakingly gorgeous. But remember, it is who you are on the inside that will always leave a footprint on our hearts. Stay strong, determined, loving, and true to your faith. Never lose those strong family values. We couldn't be any more proud than what we are now, watching you walk across the stage. We know with your determination, you will go far in life and be successful at whatever you choose to do. Your journey has just begun, Brittany, and we are all right here with you. We love you very much, BB, and we'll never be far away when you need us or just want to
pray. It doesn't always turn out like I think it should, but I do. This world's gone crazy, and it's hard to believe that tomorrow will be better than today. Believe it anyway. You can love someone with all your